This is the story of Krishna and Narakasura, and Satyabhama is also there in this.
And also, he makes the rain.
Yes, there is rain in it, wind in it, fire in it, and there is a big battle between Krishna and Narakasura. And Krishna defeats Narakasura, and it's a happy story. Yeah, but let us see how Narakasura has troubled everyone and why did Krishna have to fight with Narakasura. Yeah, so long time ago, when the earth was in danger
of,
yes, earth was in danger,
mother,
yes, mother earth, so mother earth was in danger from demons when they wanted to take the earth away and put it under the ocean. Then Mother Earth asked for help. She said, can someone take me out of the bottom of the ocean? And Vishnu came in the form of Varaha. Varaha means a boar. A boar is a kind of a pig. But it's a
pig.
Yeah, it's a wild pig. And what? It's got two tusks.
Does it harm?
It's a little dangerous. If someone goes to harm it, it will definitely fight back. It's more dangerous than the pig because it's got two sharp tooth. Yeah? But the boar lifted Mother Earth from the bottom of the ocean and put it back and saved. During that time, there was a baby who was born.
Under the ground.
Yes, kind of under the ground. Like he was born for...
Sita?
No, he was born out of...
Is it a boy?
Yeah, it's a boy. The baby was born out of Mother Earth. And the baby's name is Narakasura. Though Vishnu and Mother Earth were very good people, Narakasura happened to become a Rakshas and he was very naughty. He very much liked terrorizing everyone. Terrorizing means creating terror, like scaring everyone. So he was very strong and he was very proud of his strength. Yeah, because he was very strong, what he used to do, he used to go and attack the kings and even the gods. And he went into all the different places to attack everyone, even the rishis and swamis who are doing yajna or tapasya. He used to go and disturb them, like pulling their dress using elephants. Can you see here? The elephant is pulling the long dress that the Swami was wearing. Yeah. And everybody was scared of Narakasura. And even gods were scared because he was very strong.
But gods are gods.
Yeah.
They are the gods.
Correct. But he's the son of the god. He's the son of Vishnu. And he's the son of Mother Earth. So he's also strong. Yeah. And sometimes even gods can't defeat everyone because some of the Rakshas have gifts or boons from gods. Like, you know the story of Bhasmasura. He has the boon from Lord Shiva.
And same god from Narasimhamurti.
Hiranyakasipa.
Hiranyakasipa, the same god.
Yeah, Lord Shiva.
He said no, but he forget nails.
Yes.
Of a form of a
weapon.
Lion.
Man. Half lion, half man. Yes. So even Rakshas, they are powerful because they sometimes get the boons from the gods and they become really powerful. and only some gods can then go and defeat them. And
some gods can defeat him.
Yeah, not all gods can defeat Narakasura, but Krishna can defeat. Yeah, let us see what happens. So one day Narakasura wanted to go and capture Indra. Indra is the leader of all the gods. Yeah.
And also Krishna defeated
who?
Everybody. Prayed to the golden greed, the good of gold.
Yes. Indra was defeated by Krishna. Correct. During the story of Govardhan Hill, he defeated Indra. But Indra is also powerful. And Narakasura went to fight with Indra. And why did he want to fight with Indra? He wanted to get his elephants. Indra had so many elephants, which were all having 4 tusks. So he went and grabbed all the elephants from Indra, and Indra couldn't fight. He then charged towards Varuna, the god of rain, and he snatched Varuna's umbrella. And then even Varuna couldn't do anything. He also then went and grabbed Aditi's earrings, Aditi's mother of Indra. He grabbed the earrings and went away. So Indra had no choice but to run to Krishna and said to Krishna, Krishna, you know, the son of Mother Earth and Vishnu, Narakasura, is scaring everyone, including me. He came and snatched all my elephants, and he disrespected me and my mother and also Varuna, and he ran away with Varuna's umbrella and my mother's earrings. And Indra said he's there in Prag Jyotishpura. That's the palace where Narakasura lives, in Pragjyotishpura, and it's very difficult to go inside because it's got so many barriers that you can't cross. Yeah?
What's those?
There are rocks which are very, very hard, like mountains. Then you have wind, you have water, and you have fire. All of these block anyone from going inside the castle to fight with Narakasura. So Indra said, it's very difficult, Krishna. Then Krishna said, ha 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 ha, let us see how difficult it is. Let me go and fight with Narakasura. And Satyabhama also wanted to come and fight alongside with Krishna, because even Satyabhama is very brave and she can also fight. So even Satyabhama wanted to come with Krishna. So both of them went on Garuda. Garuda is the vehicle of...
See, Garuda Gamanata Vacharana Kamalami Hamanasiya Satuma Manetyam. That word.
Yes, exactly, that Garuda. So the Garuda came, and Krishna and Satyabhama, they both mounted on Garuda and they went to Pragjyotishpura. So as they were nearing to Pragjyotishpura, Garuda's beak suddenly hit something hard. Suddenly a big mountain like a rock came. It was not there before, and the Garuda was flying, and suddenly a big mountain came and hit Garuda's beak. And Garuda was not able to fly forward. And Garuda said, Krishna, I can't fly around this one. Wherever I am going, it's coming. appearing. It's very difficult for me to cross it. Then Krishna said, don't worry. And he took out his mace, gada, and gave one tap with his force, and he hit the mountain. What happened to the mountain? It shattered into million pieces. Shattered into million small rocks. And Garuda said, ha, I can fly now. They're all broken. And Garuda started flying. Then suddenly an arrow came from somewhere and hit Satyabhama. And Satyabhama said, oh Krishna, look, there are so many weapons coming towards us. And Krishna saw there were hundreds of weapons, all kinds of weapons, like arrows, gadas, all types of gadas, yeah, trishuls, and so many other weapons. They were all coming, flying towards Satyabhama and Krishna with a lot of speed. And even Garuda was scared. Said, oh my god, what should we do now? Krishna took out his bow and arrows.
He's holding him. He's holding her.
Yeah. Satyabhama is holding Krishna because they were sitting on the Garuda. If you don't hold, you might fall. So Krishna took out his bow and shot arrows one after the other in very quick manner, and all the arrows went and hit all the weapons that were flying towards them, and all the weapons shattered into pieces.
Arrow
went through the sword, arrow went through the mace, arrow went through the trishul, and every weapon broke into pieces. Yeah. And again Garuda was able to fly forwards, and Garuda flapped his wings very hard and flew on. Suddenly Garuda was stopped, this time by huge waves came towards Garuda, and Garuda said, oh Krishna, looks like a flood. And Krishna was not worried at all. He took out his Sudarshan Chakra and he just sent the chakra towards the waves. And the waves then all became some gentle rain. And Satyabhama, Garuda and Krishna were enjoying the rain. Satyabhama said, ah, this is very pleasant, Krishna. I like this rain. It's just so refreshing. You're so tired from fighting with all the arrows and the mountains and all of that. Thank you for the nice rain. Satyabhama said to Krishna. And suddenly, a big fire came. And all the rain evaporated. All the rain evaporated. What happens when you boil water? It becomes vapor. So there was a big rain coming, and suddenly a huge fire came, and all the water evaporated into vapor. And the fire started coming towards Krishna, Satyabhama and Garuda. Again, Krishna was not worried at all. He just took out his Sudarshan Chakra and the same one. Sudarshan Chakra always comes back to Krishna. Whenever it goes anywhere, like a boomerang, it goes, it does its job and comes back.
How?
Yeah, that's the power of Sudarshan Chakra. It always goes and comes back. Nothing happens to Sudarshan Chakra. It's very powerful. So it went and again put off all the fire, because it was rotating so fast that the air stopped the fire from coming towards Krishna and Satyabhama. They again passed suddenly big wind, like a typhoon or a cyclone or a tornado. So these are all like huge winds. Big wind came towards Garuda, and again it was pushing them into the fire. Again Krishna sent his Sudarshan Chakra, and it went, and all the wind got tamed. It mellowed down. It became gentle wind that Garuda liked. And Garuda said, "Ah, Krishna, this is very nice. I like flying in this kind of a wind. It's exactly like the wind that I want to fly in." And it started flying. Then they reached Narakasura's palace, and there was a soldier or a security guard sleeping outside the castle, and his name is Mura was sleeping, and Krishna took out his conch, which is like a shell, and blew in it. Before you fight with people, you always have to warn them. You can't just go and hit someone who's just sleeping. You have to wake them up and fight. That's dharma. It's not fair to fight with someone who's sleeping. That's cheating. So Krishna woke him up. He was sleeping. So he blew in his conch, and that big sound woke Mura up. Huh? Who is this? And he looked at Krishna and Satyabhama, said, "I think they have come to fight with Narakasura. Let me protect my king." And he said, "I will fight." So he took out his gada and he sent it flying towards Krishna and Satyabhama. And Krishna just put his mace. His mace. And Mura's mace broke into pieces. Broke into pieces. Then Mura was shouting with his faces. He had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 faces, and he was trying to shout at Krishna, and Krishna quickly put 5 arrows into the 5 mouths, and Mura was not able to talk. He was just trying to make some sounds, but he was not able to speak. Then Mura sent his Trishul, and that also was broken by Krishna by sending an arrow. Then Krishna finally defeated Mura by sending the Sudarshan Chakra. Then after that, so many soldiers came to fight with Krishna, but everybody was defeated. And then finally Narakasura wanted to fight himself, and he came. And Narakasura was very powerful, and he sent some arrows towards Krishna, and one of the arrows actually stuck Krishna, and Krishna fell down. One of the arrows hit Krishna and Krishna fell down. And Satyabhama then took Krishna's bow and arrow, because Satyabhama is very brave. Then while Krishna was fainted and he fell down, Satyabhama did war with Narakasura. And she was very good. And she sent one arrow after one arrow, one after other, and all of Narakasura's arrows were broken by Satyabhama. And Narakasura was like thinking, I thought Krishna is the main one that I have to fight with. And I defeated him. He fell down. And now Satyabhama is fighting. She's fighting so brave. Then Narakasura also started sending very strong weapons. And Satyabhama was fighting very good. And Krishna woke up and he was looking at Satyabhama. She is fighting as well. And he was also very impressed. Then after some time, Krishna said, okay, enough of you fighting. I'm back now. I just fell down for some time, but now I am awake. Let me continue the fighting. You take rest. You just sit and enjoy the fight. I will finish this.
She sat in carrot.
Yeah. She then sat on Garuda. And Garuda said, I will also fight for some time. And Garuda went and it started tickling the elephants. And the elephants couldn't bear the tickles. And they were throwing their trunks around, saying, no, stop tickling. We can't fight if you're starting to tickle us. But Garuda was very good. And all the elephants were scared and they all ran away. All the elephants and all the soldiers sitting on the elephants said, no, we can't fight with this Garuda. No matter how many arrows we send towards Garuda, it's just flying away from them and then coming again, tickling us. So all the elephants ran away. Only Narakasura remained. And now Narakasura and Krishna started fighting.
Krishna.
Did I say Krishna?
Yes. One day when you were telling Govardhangiri, you said two times Krishna. One time you said Krishna properly, one time you said Krishna.
Krishna, okay. So Krishna started fighting with Narakasura. And after some time, Krishna said, enough of this fighting. Let me just send my Sudarshan Chakra. Because he is not learning his lesson. He thinks he can still fight with us. And Krishna sent out his Sudarshan Chakra. And that went and cut Narakasura. And Narakasura fell down. And all the gods were very happy. And they all came to shower flowers on Krishna, Satyabhama and Garuda, because all three of them fought very bravely and defeated Narakasura. The end.
They were watching?
Yeah, they watched Krishna falling down, they watched Satyabhama fighting very bravely and Garuda fighting very bravely. They're watching everything. They knew that Krishna will get up and finish Narakasura. And then Krishna then went into the palace, found Aditi's earrings, and he also found the umbrella that Narakasura took, and he gave them back. And everyone was happy. The end.